Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about a very simple topic that we study, a very basic topic that we study under the heading of electrochemistry. It is standard electrode potential. In this video, I will tell you how to remember very easily. In simple words, you can remember what is standard electrode potential. So one thing that you can see, standard electrode potential term, it is a combination of three words. What are the three words? We will simply study the explanation of these three words. What are the three words of which standard electrode potential is made up of? Electrode, second word potential, and then in the end I will tell you what is the meaning of standard. Standard means we study electrode potential under standard conditions. Okay, so what you must remember, first of all, to start with, you must remember, and from your elementary classes, if you have studied chemistry, you know very well what is an electrode. Electrode is any material, any plate, any rod that is used during electrolysis, and that is a charged plate or charged rod. So generally speaking, how you can define what is electrode? It is any charged elemental plate or rod used during electrolysis. It is known as electrode. Why I'm using the word element? Because there are metals as well as non-metals which can act as an electrode. You would have studied one very common non-metal, carbon, that can also act as an electrode. So remember, electrode can be metallic or it can be non-metallic, but it must be charged and used during electrolysis. Second thing, you people know very well, there are two types of electrode. One type of electrode, it is known as anode. And the other type of electrode, it is known as cathode. Now what if I ask how you can define, how you can differentiate between anode and cathode? Do you know the difference between anode and cathode? So remember, if ever you are asked to give a difference, give a definition between anode and cathode, what you must remember, you must never give a difference definition with regard to charge on anode and cathode. You must always define, you must always give difference between anode and cathode with respect to the process. So what you must remember, what is an anode? Whenever it is asked, you must remember anode is the electrode at which always oxidation takes place. While cathode is the electrode at which always reduction takes place. So this is the exact definition of anode and cathode that you can use at any level. If you are studying chemistry, this is the best definition for anode and cathode to be remembered. And I can also tell you the shortcut to be remembered for these definitions. For cathode, what you can remember? You can remember the shortcut red cat. Red cat. Yes, red cat means red for reduction, cat for cathode. So if you remember just red cat, it will remain obvious in your mind that always reduction takes place at cathode. And if reduction takes place at cathode, which process will always take place at anode? Obviously, it would be oxidation. But you can remember a shortcut for that one also. You can remember anox. Anox means anode is for oxidation. Reduction at cathode and anode for oxidation. Okay, one thing, it has become obvious to you that what is an electrode and how many types of electrodes commonly we use in chemistry. Next comes potential. No doubt this is potential difference, but to start with, if you are trying to understand what is electrode potential, so potential, the basic meaning of potential that you can remember, you can keep in your mind, potential means ability. Ability of what? Generally, you know, in the periodic table, generally there are two types of elements, metals and non-metals. What is the ability of a metal? The metals, they are able to lose electron. Metals are able to undergo oxidation. And what is the ability of non-metals? Non-metals are able to undergo reduction. Non-metals are able to gain electron. So potential means ability. Ability can be of two different types. Ability can be to either to lose electron, or it can be the ability of an element, it can be to gain electron. Now, if an element is able to lose electron, we can say that element will undergo oxidation. And if an element is able to gain electron, that element will undergo reduction. Now, based on this information, you can remember there are two types of potential we commonly study in chemistry. One type of potential is known as oxidation potential, because it is the ability of an element to undergo oxidation. And what you must remember, when we apply this concept for voltaic cell, in which electrical energy is produced from chemical energy. What happens? The element that undergoes oxidation, that element act as anode. And anode plate, it always has negative charge. It always has negative charge. And it is the property of which elements can have oxidation potential? Mostly reactive metals, they can have oxidation potential. But compared to oxidation potential, the other type of potential is reduction potential. Now in electrochemical cell, whenever an electrode undergoes reduction, during reduction that plate, that rod act as cathode, and what charge develops on that cathode or plate? Positive charge. So you must remember these charges on the anode and cathode, I am telling you with respect to voltaic cell, with respect to galvanic cell. So remember, whenever there is an electrochemical, there is a voltaic cell, the anode is negative, cathode is positive. And it is the property of which element that they can have reduction potential? It is the property of less reactive metals and non-metals. So now you have become able, what is electrode? You have also become able to define, to give a definition, to give a wording to electrode potential. Now if someone asks, what do you mean by electrode potential? Simply you can say it is the ability of an electrode. Electrode potential. Potential is the ability. It is the ability of an electrode to undergo oxidation or reduction. And you can also remember there can be two types of electrode potential. One type of electrode potential is oxidation potential, that is the property of reactive metals. And other type of electrode potential is reduction potential, that is the property of less reactive metals and non-metals. Now comes, whenever we determine electrode potential for different elements, for getting a fair comparison, what we do? Electrode potential, they are always determined under standard set of conditions. Standard set of conditions are necessary for making a fair comparison for the process of determination of electrode potential. Now what are the common standard conditions that we use in electrochemistry? So you must remember, standard temperature, it is 298 Kelvin or 25 degrees Celsius temperature. And if ever we are having some gas involved in electrochemistry making a half cell, then for that gas we always use a pressure of 1 atm. All the solutions that we use for electrochemistry, those solution must have a concentration of 1 mole per dm cube. One more condition that is also very common we use in electrochemistry, it is sometime we use standard electrode. Standard electrode, which element we use commonly? It is platinum. Now two information you can remember. Why we use platinum? When we use platinum? One thing, why we use platinum? We use platinum because there are two reasons. Number one, platinum is a metal and it is a good conductor. And number two, it is inert, it is unreactive, it does not generate its own potential. So that is why it is used commonly. Now the second question, if someone asked when you will use platinum as a standard electrode, there are two sub conditions that you can remember when we use platinum. Whenever you are trying to make electrode of a non-metal, which is non-conductor, you will have to use platinum. So one sub condition, when you will use platinum as an electrode, whenever you are interested to make electrode of a non-metal that is non-conductor. For example, if you want to make electrode of hydrogen gas, hydrogen is a non-metal and it's a non-conductor. For making half cell, for making electrode of hydrogen, you will have to use platinum. But if you are using carbon as an electrode, you know carbon non-metal, but it is a conductor, no need to use platinum. So you got it? So whenever you are asked to use platinum, there must be some non-metal that should be non-conductor. Second condition, sometimes in electrochemistry, we use such aqueous solution containing same element into different ionic form, into different oxidation state. For example, if you have been given a solution containing iron 2 plus and iron 3 plus ions, now in this case of solution, you must use platinum as an electrode. Now, keeping in your mind this video, I think you would have become able to give a complete definition, and you can give an explanation to anyone that what is standard electrode potential. It is very simple to tell that it is the ability of an electrode to undergo oxidation or reduction under standard conditions. I hope you would have enjoyed this lecture. Thank you for your time. Bye.